Jai Hind, one and all. The topic we are going to take today is relation between electric field intensity and electric potential. We need to find the relation between electric field intensity and electric potential. Since we have already seen this diagram in the previous derivation or the topic, we are having an isolated positive charge. The electric field lines are radially outward, and this is the equipotential surface. Suppose if we just erase the half portion of this diagram, we have erased the half portion of this diagram. Okay, so we have this much. Okay, our aim is to move a test charge from this surface to this surface, or from this surface to the surface, whichever you like. Okay, so this is the first equipotential surface, this is the second equipotential surface. We are trying to move a test charge from first equipotential surface to second equipotential surface. We have already studied that if the equipotential at this surface is V and potential at this surface is V1, then the value of V is greater than V1. And the value of R is less than R1 if we consider this as R and this as R1. So we can see this distance as R1 and this small distance as R. Okay? Now, by this concept and by this concept, we can say that a small work is being done to move a test charge from first equipotential surface to second equipotential surface. So the equation is given by, for small work done, dW will be equals to Q into dV. Why dV? Because this is the first potential V, second potential V1. So V minus V1, you can say. Okay? Or we can also write it as a V1 minus V, final minus initial, you can write. Final one is V1, the initial one is V. So the difference is given as delta V. So difference is given as delta V. But since we are moving from a region of higher potential to lower potential, as the value is given, we are moving from a region of higher potential to lower potential. That's why a negative sign should be here. A negative sign should be here. It is your first equation. Now, if we go for the second equation, the basic formula of work done is F dot dr with a vector sign. On breaking these two, F dr cos theta. Isn't it? Now, what is the force experienced by a charge in uniform electric field? This is the uniform electric field, as you can see. This is the electric field lines, these are the electric field lines. So, what is the force experienced by a charge in uniform electric field, which is given by QEdr cos theta. So, we got equation number 1, we got equation number 2. On equating 1 and 2, we will get minus QdV is equals to QEdr cos theta. This Q will get cancelled out, and we will be left with only minus dV upon dr equals to E cos theta. Now suppose if we are moving in the direction of electric field, then this theta will be equals to 0 degree. If we are moving in the direction of electric field, then this theta will be 0 degree. So cos 0 will be equals to 1, and hence we will get minus dV upon dr is equals to E. So this is just a case. And suppose we are not moving in the direction of electric field, then this theta may be anything, and accordingly we will get the result. Thank you.